from Battle Creek, Michigan, 235 pounds, Rob Van Dam!
This is the match we have been waiting for, the stretcher match. This matchup will end only when one man is carted back to the locker room on a stretcher. Will it be Rob Van Dam or Sabu?
From Bombay, India, this is Sabu!
Got some excitable internet fans from all around the country. This feud began after Sabu had defeated Rob Van Dam in their first matchup, and Van Dam refused to accept the handshake, a show of respect from Sabu. They came back in a stretcher match. Van Dam got the Duke. Sabu extended his hand as a token of respect, as were the stipulations. And again, he was slighted by Rob Van Dam. Shortly thereafter, Sabu was caught out in a stretcher, courtesy of Van Dam, who got inside information from Bill Alfonso. And when Sabu beat Van Dam the next time out, both men were carried out on stretchers. The only way to settle this feud once and for all was this stretcher match. Sabu with a dropkick to the knee. Van Dam with a dropkick to the knee. Both wrestlers just feeling one another out at this point. Sabu hits a right hand. Van Dam connects with forearms. We've got a slugfest early on in this matchup. Taking over on Sabu, snapmare takes him out of the corner. Van Dam drops the leg. Sabu kicks Van Dam right in the face. Collar elbow tie up. Sabu rolls up Van Dam. Going to work on the leg of Rob Van Dam. Remember, no pinfalls, no submissions, no count out, no DQ. This matchup will only conclude when one man has been carried all the way to the locker room on a stretcher. Tie up once again. Van Dam back into the ropes. Van Dam with a very cocky smile on his face. Face first into the turnbuckle goes Van Dam. Irish whip. Sabu connects with a slingshot leg drop. Slingshot headbutt. Irish whip. Sabu ducks his head. Double underhook. And Sabu dropped face first to the canvas. Again, a cocky smile appears on the lips of Rob Van Dam. The slingshot splash broken up by kick. Van Dam hits the concrete.
Oh, my God!
Slingshot somersault senton. Sabu now bridging the ring in the steel guardrail with the table. Face first into the table. It's a kick right to the chest. Guillotine leg drop across the back of the neck. Took a chair right to the puss. Van Dam thrown back over the guardrail. Sabu throws a chair into the ring. Chair right to the top of the head. Van Dam being set up on the top turnbuckle. Here comes Air Sabu. No. Van Dam breaks it up. Spin kick and Sabu lands on the concrete. Van Dam now working over Sabu. Chair across the face. No, no slingshot. Van Dam going to the top.
Drops the leg.
Van Dam calling for the stretcher. This may be the end of this matchup. Damage Control is here with the stretcher. They're putting Sabu's limp body on that stretcher. And he is being wheeled towards the locker room. Not ready to go just yet. He rolls back in. Van Dam drops the knee. Press kick right to the chin. Sabu extends his hand and drops the leg. Van Dam drives the knee into the back of Sabu. Face, Irish whip. Sabu lands, no, trying to land on his feet. Leg sweep by Van Dam. Backflip splash. Sabu with a punch right to the solar plexus. Van Dam fires back. gets cut off by Sabu and a fist right to the face. Van Dam counter the superplex and snaps Sabu's throat across the top rope. Van Dam grabs the chair. Dropkick catches Van Dam coming in. Van Dam trying to make his way back in the ring, blocks the punch, lands a form of his own, cinching up Sabu now. Sabu blocks the suplex and drops Van Dam across the top rope. Being hung out to dry. There's a chair underneath the skull. Sabu going up top now.
He dropped the leg.
And now it's Rob Van Dam in trouble. Stomping Van Dam. Sabu setting up a chair. Van Dam diving at Sabu, fell inches short, and Sabu capitalized. Now turning over Rob Van Dam, not going for the cover. Instead, Sabu now setting up the chair atop the turnbuckles. Sabu ascending the turnbuckles with that chair. Rolling Arabian facebuster. And a chair to the face. Going up top once again. A leaping Arabian face buster. Sabu now calling for Rob Van Dam to be carried out on a stretcher. Damage control right there. And that may be all for Rob Van Dam. Sabu's gonna win this matchup. Van Dam is halfway up the aisle towards the locker room. No! No, Van Dam puts a halt to that stretcher ride. He's coming back. He can barely stand, he can hardly walk. This matchup is not over. Clothesline floors Van Dam. Triple jump moonsault connects. This matchup cannot end in a pinfall. This matchup can and will only come to a conclusion when one man has been wheeled all the way to the locker room of the ECW arena on a stretcher. Sabu now setting up Van Dam. Here's Sabu. Himself up. Tried to leap out of the way, but got caught in mid-flight with an air Sabu clothesline. Van Dam's on the stretcher, but I don't think Sabu wants him wheeled back just yet. Sabu has something else in mind, it would seem. Steel guardrail, he may have broken his own leg. And now Sabu is going to be put on the stretcher. Sabu may have ended this matchup for himself if he did indeed fracture or break his leg and cannot continue and must be wheeled back. It was by his own doing. Sabu obviously in a great deal of pain, clutching at his right leg. And they're gonna wheel Sabu back to the locker room. They've got Van Dam on a stretcher right behind him. Van Dam starting to come through, Sabu.
Leg drop on the stretcher.
Van Dam, he's headed back towards the ring. Van Dam, not done yet either. What courage, what heart being shown by both men. It's this type of matchup that separates Extreme Championship Wrestling from every other wrestling promotion on the planet. Sabu misses. Van Dam does not. Van Dam, it's the moonsault press. Both men down on the concrete floor. Will be back on his feet first, it would seem. Van Dam rolls in under the bottom rope. Sabu right behind him. No, Sabu calls for a chair. He connects. Set for the ride. Shoulder block. Van Dam being set up for the superplex. Here comes Air Sabu. Reverse victory roll from the top turnbuckle takes Van Dam to the canvas. To the outside.
Oh my God! Fisherman's Buster through the table!
Concrete, and that may be all for Sabu. It was the Fisherman's Buster from the second turnbuckle that first sent Sabu out on a stretcher courtesy of Rob Van Dam. This time, the Fisherman's Buster threw a table to the concrete floor, and I would have to think that is the end of this matchup. Sabu will be carried back to the locker room on a stretcher. And Rob Van Dam will get the Duke in this stretcher match. Yeah, Sabu's out.
Sabu rolls off the stretcher. He rolled off the stretcher. He wants to continue. Van Dam with a baseball slide. Both feet in the ribcage of Sabu. Sabu thrown back in by Van Dam.
Assaulting Sabu with the chair. Nothing fancy about this. Reversal on the Irish whip. Van Dam beats Sabu to the punch. Kick. Back to his feet first. Sabu blocks the Fisherman's Buster and hits one of his own. Sabu reverses the Fisherman's Buster. He sets up a chair.
The chair, Sabu face first into the steel chair.
Both men out down on the canvas. Referee John Finnegan calls for the stretcher, but for who? Sabu's not going. The spin kick takes Sabu over the top rope. Sabu landed on the stretcher. I think they're gonna wheel him to the back. This matchup may be over.
Sabu!
Oh my God, Sabu missed!
Van Dam hit the stretcher! Van Dam hit the stretcher! Van Dam hit the stretcher and then fell the back of his head. Bud, did you hear that thud on the concrete? Van Dam is out! Herb Van Dam is out. They're putting him on the stretcher. Van Dam is out cold. They're wheeling him to the back. Van Dam went for one high-risk move too many.
It's over.
It's over. Sabu has won the stretcher match. It is over.
Ladies and gentlemen.